Let me introduce myself first. My name is Shinchiba. I'm majoring in political science and especially history of Western political thought and political theory. I have been concentrating on the issues of democracy, peace, and also environment and federalism, and these themes. I want to introduce some attractive elements of our major, which is political science major or politics major. I think our faculty members have diverse backgrounds and concerns. That seems to be the most attractive element in our department and in our major. I think some of our faculty members are coming from North America, and some others are from Europe, and some of us are from Japan. So in terms of nationality and cultural background, we are very diverse and coming from different areas of the world. And also we have a diverse concern and themes in the topic of politics. And some of the members are very much interested in historical approach to politics. Some others are coming from more thought and also theory kind of approach. And some other, I think, faculty members are more interested in analytical and empirical understanding of what is happening in politics and international relations. So diversity is our attractiveness. And the second point of attractiveness is that I think we all are very much interested in going abroad to read our papers in international conferences of political science and international relations. So that's another attractive point, I think. So I think most of us are very much interested in what the problem for the world today, and what are the pressing issues of politics in national politics as well as in international politics. But this is the second attractive point. I think that we also are committed to teaching. We want to show how important and interesting political science is, and we want to share our enthusiasm and our kind of concern with students in our classes, not only through lectures, but also through exchange of opinions and dialogues. So we are very much trying to have a kind of two-way, kind of dialogical kind of teaching. I think we are giving lectures about perhaps 60% or so. Some faculty members perhaps 50% of lecture and discussion 50%. So we want to encourage students to have their own opinions and understandings, and raise some questions and make their own comments. And that's, I think, teaching style. I think this is a third attractive point that I want to commend to entering students. I have a question here. That is, what do you expect of high school students from the perspective of your major? Yes, I think politics is one of the most important problems and concerns in our life. I think that if politics is constructive and excellent, then our social and cultural life is very, very positive. But if politics is directed in a negative way, like our 15-year war period in Japanese history. Political leaders, together with military leaders, launched into a very aggressive war against Asia and Pacific nations. So I think it resulted in the very miserable, kind of, what shall I say, kind of a collective evils, you know, a collective misery. So we want to be very much interested in where politics is going to be led to, and where politics is heading for. So this is why we are very thoughtful and constructive and politically engaging citizens in order to watch where politics is going, and in order to suggest and lead our politics, where our politics should be moving. So in this sense, I think political science is very, very important, and we like to share this importance and seriousness, and also interest and even joy of learning politics. So this is what I want to share with high school students. So in terms of preparation for coming to universities, I think I want to suggest several things. One thing is, please read newspapers as well as internet articles and information. This is the internet age, so I think you adapt and amass information about politics through internet kind of means. That's understandable. But if possible, I'd like to ask high school students to read daily newspapers, and if possible, some, journal articles like Bungei Shinju, Chuo Koron, and Sekai, and these, some important monthly magazines. They provide very good information about politics, and also society, and economics, and so forth. So I'd like to ask high school students to develop your curiosity and interest by getting a lot of interesting ideas, information, and also data about society, culture, and politics. So that's my request for you. Finally, I'm asked to give you some messages. I think this is kind of an imitation to the old message, I think spoken by William L. Clark, who came to Hokkaido in Meiji period, and he was the first president of Sapporo Agricultural College, and this college later became Hokkaido University. And as you know, Clark said, boys be ambitious. Well, it was the men's college, this is why he said boys. But today I think girls and boys university and college students. So I want to say, learning from Clark's saying, boys be ambitious, I want to say and request high school students to be ambitious in a good sense. Ambitious in receiving a lot of good knowledge and ideas from education, and higher education in this time when you enter university, and also be curious all the time. Curious about what's going on in the world, and curious about what is happening to Japanese politics, and what are the pressing issues in our relation to South Korea, North Korea, and China, and the Philippines, you know, in the region of East Asia, that kind of thing. So I'm sure that in high school days, you are very busy with friends, you are very busy with preparation for entrance examination, and very busy with club activities, I know. But at the same time, I'd like to ask you to cultivate your ideas and knowledge about what's going on in your society, your culture and politics, and in region and in the world. I think in high school age, you have a lot of curiosities, and you are many concerns. But I'd like to ask you to include your interest in politics as one of these concerns and curiosities. Thank you very much.